was the most glamorous shark hunter in the world, and he was the Hollywood hunk who starred in hit movies. So how did shark expert Valerie Taylor and Blue Lagoon star Christopher Atkins become the best of friends? Craig Bennett has the story.
This is what shot Christopher Atkins to worldwide fame when he was just 19 years old.
I literally would have to go with bodyguard. There was two instances where they actually had to race me with police escort out of a building because they'd ripped my shirt and pulled my hair, and it was like a shark frenzy. It was very exciting to say that it was like a Beatles, you know, thing that happened to me.
But during that time, did he only have eyes for his beautiful co-star, Brooke Shields?
Brooke and I did have a little romance on the island, yes, we did. And when I first got there, I was living on a ship before I moved into a tent on shore. And the director would put her picture over my bunk, so I'd have to look at her every night and fall in love with her, you know. She was very young, very sweet girl.
What are you looking at?
Your muscles.
What about it?
The director wanted us to really have that connections because it shows on film. We did get very close. I think I was really the first guy to ever kiss her. I mean, she'll probably deny that, but, you know, as far as everything else goes, first of all, I'm a gentleman. and second of all, it was just a very innocent time.
The two met when the Taylors were hired to shoot the underwater footage on Blue Lagoon.
I was so new. I had no idea. I didn't even know what a camera looked like, let alone remembering lines and hitting a mark and, you know, doing all... When I was with Ron and Valerie, it was the best time ever because we just went out in a little tiny boat and, you know, and he would go down and say, okay, here's what we're going to... And then we'd just go and shoot it effortlessly. And then we'd get done so fast, we'd just go and say... She'd say, well, do you want to dive? Come on over here. We'll do... And then she'd just show me this amazing underwater world. You know, to this day, she's still doing that.
And even now, more than 35 years later, they've never lost touch and remain great friends.
I mean, look at her. She's 80 years old. She's still putting scuba tanks on, and she's still doing the thing that she loves the best and knows the best. I mean, it's her world. I mean, she is literally an animal whisperer. Fish and things just come out of places to say hi to this woman.
What is it like being underwater with Valerie and Ron?
It was just always a magical experience. They were the expert. They knew. When you're with them, you just completely feel safe. Okay, well, whatever you say type of thing. I mean, here we are with sea crates, you know, these sea snakes that are supposedly 10 times more poisonous than a king cobra. And, you know, basically one bite and you won't make it back to the boat. And she's handing them to me, saying, here, hold this, you know? And I'm like, Whoa, Valerie, didn't we talk about it? But they're very friendly. And sure enough, you know, here I am. I mean, just a couple weeks ago, we were doing it again.
Why were you and Ron so drawn to Chris?
Because he was very easy to work with. He appreciated everything we did, and he wanted to do everything we did. He never complained, even when he was cold. It was a dream to work with. And he still is a dream to work with.
Now, Chris, Valerie told me that you didn't use the body double that was provided for you on the Blue Lagoon.
Well, you're talking obviously about the nudity in the film. When you got there and you're in that situation, in that environment, just like the movie, it was a very, very natural situation. It was an all-Australian crew, and back then, you know, all the beaches and everything were all topless, and Australians are crazy, so they were basically running around naked or topless anyway.
What about the loincloth? Were you comfortable in that?
The loincloth was made up of... Why are you laughing, man? I mean, come on. You put one on and you tell me, all right?
That's why I'm laughing. It looked ridiculous. Was it ridiculous to wear?
Well, I mean, listen, you know, the wardrobe didn't have much to do on that movie.
Now, seriously, you're paying great tribute to Valerie and to Ron, yes, in a documentary that you're in the midst of shooting now.
Right. I'm very honored, and I feel compelled that since all of these years that Ron and Valerie, I've been part of their life and they've been part of my life. I admire their work, and I admire Valerie so much to this day that I just feel honored and compelled to do this documentary on her life and
her life with Ron.
Oh, Chris.
No, because honestly, she is an Australian national treasure. I recognize this, and because she is a friend of mine, I am a filmmaker. I just feel very blessed and honored to be able to have this opportunity to work with her nephew, her family, and to be able to put all this together for her. But also to be able to show Australia to stand up and be proud with some of the people, and as a woman, to do the things that she's done in her life is absolutely remarkable.